Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at everything solar. I'm Warren, and today with me is Larry, and we're going to talk about the IQ8's daylight backup, what it does, what parts you need, how do you make it work. So Larry, tell us a little bit about exactly, first of all, what is daylight backup from the IQ8s?
Yeah, so daylight backup is a product that you can get from Enphase with the IQ8 system. It's been something they've been working on for a number of years. It's probably been well over 3 years since they've been started working on that. It's really an engineering feat. It's a really neat feature. It allows you to back up loads when the sun is shining and the grid is down without batteries, which is really unique in the industry.
Is that truly backing up loads or just allowing you to use energy from the solar array when the power's down?
It's a really good point. It's technically just allowing you to use available energy that your system's producing at any given point in time for those loads.
So other than the solar panels and the IQ8 inverters, what other components do you need to make it work?
Yeah, so it's important to note that the IQ8 doesn't come ready for daylight backup just by itself. You have to add a system controller, which allows you to disconnect from the grid during an outage. And then typically we would recommend two load controllers, which you would then connect your loads to actually back up those specific loads during an outage.
And then if you're looking at just a regular IQ8 system versus an IQ8 system with daylight backup, what's the cost differential?
Typically for the parts, installation, it's gonna be about $5,000 to add that in.
And then realistically, what are you looking at actually running? Can you run, how many loads, different loads, what type of loads can you run?
Yeah, so you can do a total of about 64 amps of solar with daylight backup, which means that if the system is maxing out in the middle of the day, you can run 64 amps of loads. Typically what we tell customers is figure on about 30% of your solar being available at any given time. You're gonna have clouds, might have snow on some of the panels. So if you've got 64 amps, maybe figure on having 20 amps available at any given time during the day.
How does that equate to the size of your system? If you have a 10 kW system, what does that mean in terms of the loads?
So if you have a 10 kilowatt system, you probably have about a 9 kilowatt system AC size.
Right.
And then you'll probably have 3 or maybe just under kW worth of backup.
So if you want more than the 3,000 watts to use, and you actually want to use it maybe when the sun's not shining, what are your options?
Yeah, so if you want to use power during the night, or during the winter time when it's not producing as much, or you want more than those approximately 3,000 watts, you can actually add a battery in. And then when you do that, and you have loads running when the grid is down, you can pull power from the battery or from the solar or both to actually increase the number of loads that you can power at that point. The other really neat thing about sunlight backup is Enphase is the only product that I'm aware of on the market today where you can actually use the sunlight backup with a generator. So if you have your generator running but you want to save fuel, you can actually use the sunlight backup feature to cut your fuel load a little bit during the day and actually use some of that power.
And it'll integrate seamlessly with
Correct.
The generator.
Correct.
Thanks for watching. Hope you found this informative. If you want to watch more videos like this on solar energy, feel free to click on either of the videos that pop up.